One of the biggest benefits of using a mirrorless camera is that you can use tools to guarantee that your photos aren't overexposed before you ever take the shot. Let's go ahead and look in the Panasonic S1 and S1R to see what tools they offer to make sure you're not getting overexposed photos. In the camera's menu, we have a cog, which is this tab here, also known as a gear. From this tab, we want to go to the top camera symbol logo. We have an option for histogram. Go ahead and turn this on. You can also move the histogram either with the arrow keys, or you can just grab it and move it with your finger. Now that we have it, you can see that our histogram shows the left is the black parts of the image, most likely this area here, and the right here is the white areas of the picture, so this area most likely here. If it's touching the right wall, that means something in your picture is overexposed. But it doesn't tell you what's overexposed. So let's go ahead and look at our zebra function and see how that can show us what's over. Go into the camera's menu. Now we need to go to the third camera option, and we have an option that says zebra pattern. We have two different zebras. We can set one differently than the other. So in the case of the top one, we have it set to 80%. You could set it to a low point as low as 50. You could set it to a high point as high as 105. We're going to leave it at the default setting. Zebra 2, you could also change that to 105. I usually only do that if I'm shooting raw because I know I might be able to recover that information in a post edit. For this video, we're going to just keep it at 100%. Now we're going to go ahead and turn on Zebra 2, which is our 100% zebra. And you can see all of this little striped area is showing us that this area is overexposed. If I make an adjustment to my exposure compensation and begin to turn it down, you can see that we've moved the exposure so it's no longer touching the right wall. See, just a little faint bit of overexposure there, so we can go ahead and bring it down even further if we'd like. And we can start to get rid of those zebra patterns. We're going to go ahead, though, and take a picture that's overexposed. Now, what if you'd like to see if a picture is overexposed after you've taken the photograph? From the camera's menu, turn on blinking highlights. From here, if I play back a photo, you'll get blinking black areas, any area of the picture that was overexposed. And those are the different exposure tools in the S1 and S1R.